You can integrate indirect, capital, and non-sponsored project types from the EPM Planning Projects module with Project Management. After you create and approve projects in the EPM Projects module, send them to Project Management for detailed task-level budgeting and control. This series covers the tasks to integrate EPM Planning and Project Management. In this fourth video, we'll look at the steps required to configure mappings and integration options for EPM Planning and Project Management. After initializing integration definitions, you'll need to review and update them based on your implementation requirements. You'll need to complete one or more of these tasks for each integration definition. First, map source and target dimensions. Second, set filter options. Third, set calendar integration options. Navigate to data integration. Here are the initialized integration definitions for EPM planning and project management. The integration jobs prefixed with C1 are associated with the Vision Operations Business Unit and PPM 445 accounting calendar. Import project budgets. I'll edit import project budgets. If a custom dimension, such as vendor or phases, is enabled, set the target dimension to a default member. Map the ledger currency source dimension to the target currency dimension. In filters, set the business unit filter value for this integration job. Setting a maximum age of completed projects lets you filter projects completed within a number of days. In general options, set the period mapping type to explicit and select the period you define in source mapping. I'll save my changes. Import project actuals. I'll perform similar tasks for import project actuals and save my changes. Map the ledger currency source dimension to the target currency dimension. In filters, set the accounting calendar for this integration job. In general options, set the period mapping type to explicit and select the period you defined in source mapping. Import projects. For import projects, I'll modify integration options and save my changes. I'll specify the business unit and maximum age of completed projects. I'll set the period mapping type to explicit and select the period defined in source mapping. Export project budgets. For export project budgets, we'll start by mapping dimensions. Map the currency source dimension to the target planning currency dimension. To copy existing source values, I'll add the copy source target expression. Map the financial plan type. You define the financial plan type in project management. This determines how budgets will be defined when pulled from EPM planning. Review source and target mappings for resource member names. If default mappings need to be changed to match your requirements, modify selections in map members. For integration options, I'll review and modify filter values based on the data point of view I am exporting, and verify that the period mapping type is set to default. Export projects. For export projects, I'll set and verify integration options and save my changes. Import project properties and exported project status sync. If a custom dimension is enabled, make sure to map the target dimension to a default member in both import project properties and exported project status sync. Related videos and the unified planning, budgeting, execution, and analysis of project technical brief are linked in the description. See how you run these integration jobs in the integrating projects in EPM planning with project management video. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.